So the main theory in this chapter is referred to as the quantity theory of money, and it's really simple. It's the idea that the quantity of money determines the value of that money. So if you double the quantity of money, it becomes half as valuable. So if you think about it in general, when something becomes more plentiful on the planet, its value tends to decrease. Well, it's the same thing with money. If money becomes more plentiful, then it's less valuable. So if you had, for example, a chocolate bar that was $1 and you doubled the quantity of money, well, then instead of needing $1 for that chocolate bar, you would need $2. So in this scenario, to buy the same chocolate bar, you need twice the amount of money. So its value, each dollar, has been cut in half. Now, if you need $2 to buy the chocolate bar, $1 is not going to get you the whole thing, right? You need twice the amount of money. So if you double the quantity of money, it becomes half as valuable. So the chocolate bar example, starting out with $1 equals one chocolate bar, double the quantity of money, the dollar has to become less valuable. So then its value gets cut in half. So you need $2 to buy one chocolate bar. And notice what would happen to the price. The price of that bar would go from $1 up to $2, which would be inflation. So this is really the long run theory that printing money just causes inflation because it's really the idea that the quantity of the money determines its value. And therefore, more quantity. Right, the value is less, which means you need more dollars for each item. More dollars for each item is inflation. One last point on this. Most economists believe this is true in the long run, meaning that once there's enough time for prices to adjust, this is what will happen when you print money. In the short term, the modern view of the world is a little bit different. In the short term, money might not be as neutral on the economy as it is in the long run. When I mean neutral, meaning impacting real variables like GDP or unemployment rate or real production of a country. So just make a note that this chapter really deals with the long run behavior when you print money, and it's basically saying it will just cause inflation and have no impact on any of the real variables like real GDP, your unemployment rate, and your economy.